Greetings, internet, and welcome back. I'm Angelos, I'll be your host, and you're listening to the Papas Film Show. Cue the intro. So, it's been 2 weeks since I last recorded an episode of the Papas Film Show. Last week, I honestly couldn't record an episode because I had my C2 English exams, so I was really tired when I came back, and I just couldn't start the recording session back then, and also, I didn't really have a theme or a topic to cover. But now, I think it was a week ago, it was the 30th of June, System 76 released PopOS version 2104, or it's more like 2106, since the PopOS distro uses the Ubuntu release numbering system. So 2104 means the year 2021, and then 04, the month, so April of 2021. But PopOS 2104 was released on June 30th. So that was more like 2106. But anyway, there are quite a lot of features, of new features that we have here. And the first one, and the biggest one, is that they have forked GNOME officially, and they're calling it Cosmic, the Cosmic Desktop. Now, I think there is like a section on the website that say what Cosmic stands for. I don't remember, but it's somewhere here, I think. Yeah, it's somewhere here, I just can't really see. I don't remember where it is, but it is somewhere here. And if I'm being honest, I really like the Cosmic Desktop. I really like it. I don't like how it's configured out of the box with this weird like panel that extends to the edges, like, yeah, a dock panel. Yeah, I don't like that, especially if you have a wide ratio screen. So you would prefer that to be on the left side of your screen and not the bottom. And if they're gonna put this on the bottom, then shrink it. Don't make it extend to the edges of the screen. But yeah, that was the biggest change. They also have gotten rid of the unified workspaces and applications launcher. So now workspaces and applications are two different screens triggered with different buttons. And they also have their new launcher. It's basically like the menu, but you also have web and terminal and other stuff that you can do with it, like running commands and stuff. Yeah. Quite a good release. I don't know if there are any other changes. The Pop Sale got some updates and quality of life improvements. And that's it mostly. Yeah, that's everything about PopOS. Now, I started a live stream when it came out. I think it was the day after. And I started, or it was the same day, I don't remember. And I installed it on my main computer, external SSD. And just started comparing it to my Fedora and everything. And I really enjoyed it. But I don't really like Ubuntu-based distributions. Okay, I just don't really like them. Don't get me wrong, Ubuntu is a fantastic distribution, especially for beginners. But having used Fedora for over 1.5 years now, and also having used Arch for a couple of months, I'm used to having bleeding edge software. So if the latest version of the program is version number 8, Ubuntu will have version number 5 or 6, and Fedora will have number either 7 or 8 version. So yeah, as you can see really the difference there. Now, I know that System 76 backports a lot of features into PopOS releases, which is something that I really, really like. And they also update and keep their own versions of packages through the apt manager that a lot of people use. So for instance, Steam is the latest version through the apt manager. They have their own repositories and they keep this up to date, which is something really good. I'm not sure if Kden Live is one that they maintain and build themselves. I don't know. But they also have Flatpak installed and configured out of the box, which is good. Now, Flatpak, you can install it yourself. You don't really need to have this distro have it included because it's super easy to actually do that. But yeah, being configured out of the box means that you can also use the PopShop, which is the elementary app center, to install Flatpak apps. And talking about elementary, I just want to touch on the like the elementary and System 76 partnership, because the actual installer that PopOS uses is a partnership between System 76 and elementary, the elementary team. And it's weird how PopOS uses the elementary installer for more years than elementary. Elementary OS hasn't even started using it. They will now with elementary OS 6, which, as Nick said from the Linux experiment, we all have to make sure that we have kids so that there's at least someone left to review this distro. But anyway, if it ever comes out before 2204 releases, which will be in less than a year now, so elementary OS team, please do not release elementary OS 6. Just wait and release elementary OS 7. That's the best thing that you can do. Backport everything. Yeah. Anyway, also the PopShop is the elementary app center, so they do share quite a lot of stuff. And one thing that I really would like PopOS to do is to get rid of the default GNOME settings. Maybe keep the same actual settings, but just change the frontend, the GUI. Maybe use the elementary OS one, because it's a really awesome settings panel. And yeah, it's better to keep everything unified and not having to install tweaks and everything. Now, this comes from a GNOME user that also uses Fedora, so I do have a lot of extensions and tweaks enabled and stuff, but I wish that everything was in just one simple application settings, yeah, like KDE does. That would be really amazing if I'm being honest, and also Cinnamon does that. And also, why not change the naming scheme? Yeah, why have 2104, and why release two versions of your distro each and every year? Now, yeah, it's Ubuntu based, so they have to do that. Yeah, but why not just take your time to actually make it the perfect distro, iron out every single bug, because on release date there were quite a lot of bugs that I found out. You can click the link in the show notes to go and see the video, if I remember to put it there. It's a live stream, by the way, and it was really laggy and the audio quality was not good since I was streaming from a Chromebook, but I really like PopOS. Being based on Ubuntu, I don't really like it. But yeah, PopOS is such a fantastic distro. Yeah, not for me, but like for my dad. That's amazing. And that's basically everything that I had to say about PopOS. And yeah, I'm now going through the actual website to see if there's any differences. Oh yeah, the installer, for some reason, now doesn't do OEM installs by default. And I'm not sure if you can enable them some way. I'm not sure why the PopOS team did that. But now, when you install your distro, it will ask you to create a user account and passwords while you're installing. On previous versions of the PopOS distribution, you could do that after the first reboot, which would be amazing for OEM installations. Now they don't do that. It's probably because now with encryption, they have a little tick box that says if you want to use the same password as your user account for encryption, which is something that I did. Yeah, that's cool, but why do that? Like, really, really, why? I love OEM installations, okay? Fedora does that to some degree with Workstation. All the other spins don't do that for some reason. I'm not sure why. But Fedora Workstation, which is the one that I use, version 34, does that by default. So yeah, hopefully, they will introduce like an option on Grub to bring back the old OEM installations, keep those tapes, and then do the GNOME welcome screen. I'm guessing that the main reason they didn't do that is that they use the GNOME welcome screen to customize Cosmic. So why not create a new welcome screen? Now, I know that these are a lot of features that I'm asking for here, but since PopOS is an amazing distribution as it is right now, well, with the next version, they wanted to introduce like major fixes or like major new features. Just do these small changes. Like, yeah, why not? And now I'm realizing that this episode so far has only been 10 minutes. So, yeah, we're not only gonna talk about PopOS as it turns out. So, let me just take a break and I'll be back soon. Maybe you'll hear an ad, maybe not. Okay, so I'm back. And I found out two subjects that I can briefly touch on. And the third one will be my distro homing experience that I left unfinished on the last episode. But for the second one right now, I'm gonna talk about my headphones. If you didn't know, I have the Razer Kraken Pro V2s as my main headset and my only one technically. I do have some wireless ones and some Sony really bad and old ones, but my main set of headphones are the Razer Kraken Pro V2s. Amazing sound, amazing build quality, comfort is okay, not the best, but yeah. And the problem that I have with these, I know that might sound weird to you, the problem is that the like little things that they have, the cushions, the leather has almost entirely peeled off. Yeah, and I'm trying to like find the perfect example. Maybe I'll snap a picture later and put this on a PDF on the show notes. But yeah, it has peeled off almost completely. And it's now really uncomfortable for me to wear this for more like 30 minutes or so. I do still use them like 5 hours a day, even more. But yeah, it's really uncomfortable now. And also the leather sticks to my head, to my ears. And yeah, when I walk away from my computer, maybe I go to the toilet and I see myself, my reflection in the mirror, and I see these little black spots. And I'm like, what's that? Oh yeah, it's leather from my Razer Kraken Pro V2s. So I was looking to buy the replacements for the cushions, but as it turns out, because like the actual like Razer repair shop is not really a thing in Greece, they ship them to the big companies that fix your stuff. But when we went to one of those, they said that the only thing they can do is to purchase a replacement that was not even an official product that Razer made. So it was a third party one, a knockoff. And we were like, what's the price? And they said, 50 euros plus the installation. What? Have you seen how easy it is to remove the cushions on these headphones? You just turn them 90 degrees to the left and they just pop out. And then you do the same exact thing to place them back on. So it's not really an installation fee that should be more than 10 cents or something. So I went into bestprice.gr or Scrooge or all of these websites, not sponsored by the way, and I started looking at replacements. Every single one was a knockoff, and one that seemed that was from like an actual brand that makes knockoffs was 35 euros. So there's no way I'm purchasing this. And I started looking for alternative to headphones, and I'm like, hey, since this is 35 euros, maybe I can put another like 15 and purchase the Sennheiser HD 280 Pro or 200 Pro. I don't remember which one it was. But I watched reviews and I didn't really like them. The reviews said that they were amazing, but I don't think that I'd love them. And so I found one of my favorite pairs for a really good price. I found them, the cheapest price is 134.99 euros. And the headphones are the Beyerdynamic DT70, no, 770 Pro, the 80 ohms version. And I really like those headphones. And I know that they're awesome headphones. I think they have been making these since 1980 or something. So yeah, I really like those headphones. I've seen loads and loads of reviews saying that K is the best one. Now, the reviews here on the website say that you might need a DAC, like digital to analog converter, or a sound amplifier or something to use the 80 ohms version properly. Now, other reviews that I've seen say that you don't, that they work all right without one. So I'm not sure what I'll do. If I end up getting these, I'll probably spend some more money to buy a DAC, or maybe I'll leave it for a couple of years, maybe, and then I'll buy a DAC or something. I'm not 100% sure what I'll do. And also, I really like the color, like the leather that have on the cushions. That's amazing. So, yeah, if something breaks, you can fix it yourself. and that's also really great. Now, the price is not really the best, €135. It's really good for those headphones, but mine right now, I cost like 80. So, yeah, it's almost twice as much. It's a little bit less than that. But yeah, I think they're worth it. And maybe like next year, maybe I'll get that. I also want to get an Apple Watch, but maybe I'll get the headphones instead. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'll do. Like, I need the watch because I have right now the Mi Band 4. It's getting really outdated and I don't really like how it looks and stuff. So I want a smartwatch, but the only good smartwatch for me since I have an iPhone is the Apple Watch. And I was looking at the SE, but it's too expensive in Greece. So I don't know what I'll do. Probably the headphones. Who knows? But yeah, that was the second subject. So the episode should be around like 15 minutes right now. I'm sure that this is a shorter episode, but anyway, let's get on to the third and last subject for this episode. So, last episode, which was 2 weeks ago, I said how I distro hope to Endeavor, or Art, I don't remember. Yeah, and then to Endeavor, and I started using KDE. And it was a distro hope that I really enjoyed. I got to use KDE again after more than a year. And yeah, it was really, really amazing, but I had a problem, okay? I had a really big problem, and that problem was that with DaVinci Resolve, I couldn't get any audio output. When I exported the video, yes, but I couldn't get audio output while editing, which, if you know anything about editing, it's not good. So I tried some fixes, and I realized that that's a problem with Arch Linux for some reason, no idea why. And I was like, okay, I really need to hop again because I have a project for my school starting soon. And I know that summer, and especially for us in Greece, summer is 3 months. So I'm starting school again mid-September. But we do something for summer, especially this year because it's 200 years like Greece independence. So we had to do something about that. And we have started a project with my school teacher. And yeah, I had to edit a lot of footage and I had to distro hop again. So I just picked the easy way, the easy route, and I installed Fedora Workstation 34 again. I customized it the way that I customized it before. And I haven't done anything since then. I was considering going to PopOS, but it's Ubuntu based, so I'm not really into that. Maybe I will try KDE again in the future. Especially with version 5.23, they have the new Breeze theme. And I know that sounds weird, but when I was using KDE, I was using the Breeze dark theme, the default one. No, the default one's the white, but the dark variant of the default theme. And the reason was that I just really like it. Okay, so I hope that the new redesign will be something cool. I watched the KDE developer live streaming the customizations that they're doing, so maybe it will turn out good. Now, with the customizations that they've done so far, I can't really see the changes. They're like mostly under the hood and stuff, but I hope that it will turn out good. And then maybe I will try a distribution with KDE. I'm not sure if it's gonna be Ubuntu based or maybe it's gonna be Fedora based, but oh, yeah, I just remembered. When I wanted to jump back to Fedora, since I was using KDE, I was like, let's use Spins. KDE, Fedora Spins, KDE Plasma version. But I can't. Why? Because they use Wayland by default. And so whenever I was booting the live USB, it will just crash. The distro will just hang there. I couldn't control Alt-F4, couldn't do anything. So yeah, that was a bummer. I saw some like articles online saying that you need to disable the open source NVIDIA drivers. So you had to add some kernel parameters. I did that through grab, no mode set. And it worked. I went to the live version with not the proper screen resolution installed to an external SSD. And then when I boot back up, I had the same problems. And I'm not sure if you know, but KDE disables grab by default. It's installed, but you don't see it. If that hard drive that you installed on to has no like other operating system. Yeah, I think the delay is just on 0 seconds or something. I remember that you used to see it, especially after doing some updates with Fedora 31, That was when I was also using Fedora. I think I've used every single Fedora version since Fedora 30. I've used Fedora 30 for, that was less than a week. Then I used Fedora 31 for a month or so, Fedora 32 for another couple of months, then Fedora 33 for a year, maybe a little bit more, and now Fedora 34 since day one, since release. So, yeah, can't wait for Fedora 35. Yeah, also another change that I did, I changed my web browsers. I went Brave full-time. I'm right now running the Brave nightly build. They don't update it every night. It's like more like once a week or so that they update it. But yeah, it's good. I haven't had any problems with it being on the nightly branch. Everything works perfectly fine. I have like 0.158 BATs. That's like 0.10 United States dollars. I'll get them in 2 days or so, added to my wallet. And I don't like the sync that Brave has by default. I really hate that sync. So that's why I still have Vivaldi installed. And so whenever I want to distro hop, if I want to, I can just install Vivaldi, export my bookmarks after syncing, which Vivaldi has the best syncing any web browser has, and then install Brave and import them there. Now, Brave Nightly has a kind of a better sync. It has Sync V2. Which I know is better because now syncs extensions and apps, but you need to have at least two devices connected, not like Vivaldi, which you just have one. Now, that's good because you know that the data doesn't go through the Brave browser. It's not stored there, like with Vivaldi. My data is now being stored on Vivaldi, but it's like more convenient if you have that, so I'm not willing to change it. But yeah, so far, Brave's amazing. I really like Brave Rewards, and it's way faster than Vivaldi. What else changed? The latest Proton experimental version has finally support for OMSI2. Proton, I think 4. Something or early versions of Proton 5 had support for OMSI2. Like OMSI2 was running perfectly fine, and then I'm not sure what happened, but suddenly the game will not work. It will launch, and when the new game menu popped up, which is like an automatic process that OMSI does, it would just throw an error message and then crash. And now it worked. I actually installed it to test out on PopOS because PopOS was the last distro that could run OMSI2. And I tried that and I installed it through my main, the Fedora installation, and then I would just import the game onto PopOS. But I realized something. I pressed play to make sure that everything is installed, and it would actually launch and play, and you can install mods and everything. So that's exactly what I did, and I'm planning on live streaming the game if a certain mod works. Okay, so yeah, that game works. Hiroki Games Launcher also works amazingly well, not with Proton for some reason. It works with Wine, and it used to be exactly the opposite when I first tried it on version 4, I think it was. Now we're Heroic version 8 or something. Yeah, Heroic is an amazing project. Now, this episode should be around 25 minutes long. I know that latest episodes have been quite short. I just don't really have anything to talk about. That's why I leave. I was not making regular episodes of Tax Talk. I want to make sure that I had a lot of subject to talk about. And yeah, though that 13-minute limit was not the best, the latest episode of Tax Talk, episode 5, that's why I streamed it live, so that I could do the full 45 minutes. Now, yes, it had like 10 minutes intro and outro, but yeah, it was longer than that at least. But anyway, that's everything that I had to say about my distro hopping experience. I wish that I can stay on Fedora till version 35 and then upgrade, and everything should go better because I haven't changed the actual fonts. I'm not sure if you know, but when I changed my phones on Fedora 33, I thought that nothing bad would happen. But then a couple of months ago, Fedora 34 came out and I upgraded and I had basically no phones. Yeah, I couldn't do anything. Good thing is that I purchased a brand new M2 SSD, so I just installed it there on day one, so everything was better. And yes, I also got my phone the same day. I was actually recording a video showcasing my new phone. I was showcasing my new phone, comparing it to my old one, and then the upgrade came through. I started it and be like, hey, I will do this later. And I actually never edited it. I still have the footage. Maybe I will do like MatPat did. Hey, this is the lost episode of Papa's Films. But anyway, yeah, that's everything I had to say about my distro hopping experience. So yeah, that was everything I had planned for today's episode. I'm really sorry that this can't be a longer episode, and actually this is Monday that I'm recording. Normally I record on Thursdays for the Papa's Film Show. Yeah, I'm getting really out of track right now with recording. I'm sorry for that, but yeah, it's taking quite some time to actually make this episode, and I'm not sure if I'll be able to release it tomorrow. And in case you didn't know, new episodes get released every Tuesday at 12 p.m. Eastern Europe time zone. Yeah, now that's not the same for everywhere. You get access to like the preview of the episode on Patreon 24 hours ago, and then at around 11 o'clock you get access on Odyssey, then 12 o'clock you get access on YouTube, then 12:30 or something you get access on Patreon, full access on Patreon for everyone. Like, you can view, it's not hidden, you don't have to purchase your tier to actually see it. It's not locked, not hidden. Yeah, it becomes like unlocked. And then Spotify should be available at around 1 o'clock, Apple Podcasts 3 to 5 days later, if they actually do that. Sometimes I need to wait 5 or more weeks. I remember the first episode needed 2 weeks to actually be pushed to Apple Podcasts. Then Breaker and Pocket Cast should be around 1 to 2 days. And Anchor will be 12 o'clock tomorrow, Tuesday. So, yeah. I'm not sure what I'll name this episode. Yeah, again, go leave suggestions on Twitter what I should cover for the next episode. That's everything I had to say. Now, I'm not sure about next week's episode, if I manage to record one. I'm not really sure. If I don't have anything to talk about, I won't. Or maybe I'll do like a really short one. But yeah, that's everything that I had to say. I still don't have an outro for the Papa's Film Show. So maybe I can just like do my normal one and add some music there, but hey, that's just a theory. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not gonna do that. So yeah, anyway, that would be it. I'll see you in Tuesday, one Tuesday. I'm not sure what Tuesday is gonna be. Yeah, have a good one. Peace out. And also remember to drink water. It's like 40 degrees outside.